The New York Jets, the helmets were awesome. What the hell happened to Mike White's arm? All right, because afterwards he was saying, well, it started to feel better towards the end of the game. I don't know, man. Something seems a little off with that whole injury. What are we talking about here, Brady?
What are you trying to allude to?
I'm just saying, like, it just feels like threw a touchdown pass and was like, gosh, you know, something's going on here. I don't know if I could be out there. Like, maybe he doesn't want to, you know, put any bad tape out, try and get a contract or something. I don't know.
Are you trying to lead to a conspiracy theory?
Are you leading
to a conspiracy theory?
Listen, I don't feel like this is a conspiracy theory. I found it a little bit strange. Update. I did find it a little bit strange that he left the game and then the injury started feeling better towards the end of the game and he alluded to it after. It just seemed a little off to me. I don't know.
Why would you say it feels better at the end of the game if you're trying to stay out of the game?
I don't know. It just seems weird.
I would say this. If we're going to play out this potential conspiracy theory. It would make some sense, right? He absolutely balled out when he got his opportunity the last game. This game got off to a little bit of a slow start on the first drive, but then comes right back around, ties it up, throws a touchdown pass. It's even, and then he suffers the injury, which, look, he knows Zach Wilson's coming back. Zach Wilson was out there warming up before the game. He admitted as much, saying this is his team. I think if Wilson comes back and plays poorly,
they got to.
I mean, and obviously, they're going to play poorly. You got to give Mike White a little bit of something, right?
That's the have to. Listen, this puts a ton of pressure on Zach Wilson. A ton of pressure. Because now you're talking about a team that's looked way more competitive under Mike White's lead than they have with Zach Wilson.
And by the way, Zach Wilson, I mean, we're going to, you know, I mean, that is your guy. I think we should point that out.
You were on that bandwagon with me.
I don't remember this. All right. I did call that. The great white hype. The great white hype that is Mike White. It was kind of like that movie. It was a little bit like that movie, right?
All right. So
I just like how you called me. It's fine. I said it.
Because if it's not me, it's going to be some a-hole on Twitter.
Here's what's crazy, right? What rookie quarterback is tearing it up?
Mac Jones. But that's about it.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's about it.
Truth.
And Trevor Lawrence, you watch Trevor Lawrence the last two weeks, and he's in the best situation.
Like I think you put Trevor Lawrence in that situation. Trevor Lawrence probably looks the best.
But that's the point. That's what we all go through, Brady.
Yeah.
That's what we all go through. Like, oh, why is this guy so much better in the league than this guy was in college? The organization?
Yeah.
Period.
Are the Indianapolis Colts, are they back? Are the Colts back? How are we feeling about Carson Wentz and company? I mean, this is... listen,
is last night any indicator? I mean, let's be real.
I didn't see any neck acne. That had to have been the biggest win of the entire evening.
That was a big win, he got mascaraed up so he didn't lose on the prop bet monster.
Somebody told him about the show?
Like, where does Jonathan Taylor rank amongst running backs in the NFL?
He's the best in the game right now.
He's a stud.
Alvin Kamara, who's better? A better runner in the league? I think he's the best in the league right now.
Bro, the long run he hit, like, he's got such good vision and patience, which is, like, it's tough for a young player to do, right? Because you kind of get the football and you're like, I just want to go, and I don't want to be around a crowd of people. I want to get out to open space. He showed such patience, and they actually showed a behind look at it. And when they stopped it, I'm like, you got to be really good to know that hole's about ready to open up to his right. And he just hesitated just a second, made a jump cut, and was gone. He was out of that thing. And you can say whatever you want about the Jets, but, like, Jonathan Taylor is special. If they have any chance, it's actually kind of funny, right? Like, the AFC South, Derrick Henry's now out.
Yeah.
Now, like, maybe the Russian King's Jonathan
Taylor,
right?
Well, Derrick Henry was in. Derrick Henry's the best running back in the game. Today, Jonathan Taylor's the best running back in the game.
Yeah, awesome. I'll say this. He's the best in the AFC South. Like, I think that's why he gives them a shot, you know, or we're not counting them out right now.
That man almost put 200 beans up on their tails. 172? The thing about him, you know, and I'm a big tenor, so I pay attention. He almost broke Ron Dane's record, man.
Right.
Like, he almost became the all-time leading rusher in the NCAA history.
You played against Ron Dayne, right?
Yeah.
How good was he?
Good.
He was a big boy, too, wasn't he?
He was nimble. He was a big bull that could move, like, side to side, stopping. I mean, yeah, man. Ron was the real deal. Now, it didn't translate well into the NFL, but in college, sheesh. The Great Dane, that dog had some bite. It wasn't all bark. It was bite. And Jonathan Taylor is a much better – I won't say much better athlete, but in terms of explosiveness and movement, dude is legit. He's legit.
He's got that track speed. Like,
yes,
that's what
he
has. You can tell. Once he gets the open field, like, he's gone.
He's legit, man.
You know what's funny, dude? We're talking about, like, all-time greats like a Ron Dane or Jonathan Taylor. Was it LaMichael James at Oregon?
Yeah.
Like one of those running backs. He did it like 3 years. It was ridiculous, though, when you look at actually like his total rushing yards and what he did in 3 years versus what others did in four.
Huh.
It was absurd if you go back and look that up.
He was in fast forward. LaMichael James.
Like, he was like over like 5,000 yards or something in like 3 years.
He is like a flea. Like he's just moving from body to body, just quick.
Is there any threat to the Tennessee Titans in Indianapolis? Is that any threat whatsoever? Because they are playing better. We'll give them credit. And now the Baltimore loss just looks worse and worse now because that's going to be a big deal towards the end, the game that they completely gave away. I mean, they do look better. Carson Wentz didn't throw an interception with the wrong hand, which I think is a sign of improvement there for old Carson. But I still feel like Tennessee's going to run away with this.
I just
division.
Need to see Tennessee without Derrick Henry for a couple years.
And that's the key.
Right.
Because like, it's a different team.
Like, what does it look like now with Adrian Peterson? I need to see that first.
We know what it is. Tannehill, they said Tannehill's career is magically revived. Yeah, it was revived by this doctor named Derrick Henry.
Dr. Henry.
Did Dr. Henry got him paid?
Oh, man.
Hey, but you know what? I give Tannehill credit. He played it. He played his cards correctly. He went there.
Yeah, he Mike White-ed it.
Yeah,
that's essentially what he did.
That's how it's done. I still look at it and I go, I think Tennessee's the team to beat there. But maybe if Jonathan Taylor keeps playing the way that he does and Indianapolis gets better and better. I mean, and who was the offensive lineman who caught the touchdown pass last night?
Pinter.
Yeah, Pinter. I mean, look at that.
By the way, that was like a sneaky design play, though.
It was.
I was looking at it. I was like, wait, is that legal? Oh, okay. The tight end was off the ball, so it wasn't covered up. That was a little sneaky little NFL deal.
That's if you're an offensive lineman and you get a touchdown like that, and I think he's from Indiana. I think he grew up in the area. That's got to be, I mean, you're holding on to that football forever and ever. That is awesome, man, seeing how that all plays out.
Yeah.
And, you know.
Secret ingredient to, I think, the Colts' success moving forward, witch hazel. I think that's probably what they use in the back of Carson Wentz's
neck. Yeah, it works well.
Just tasteless here on
it
Fox Sports.
Very well.
I mean, we can't do a legit.
Right?
Yeah.
Get that close razor shave to make sure the lines look good. Get some witch hazel on there.
Just classless behavior here on a
football
Friday.
It has an interesting smell to it, but, you know, nonetheless, it's very effective.
Yeah. Witch hazel does?
Yes.
Witch hazel, yeah.
Why can't you just literally hit that song?
It doesn't smell like a fart.
Like a bunch of 10-year-olds doing sports. Sports talk radio.
It doesn't smell like a flagellation. It's a different smell. It's a weird little smell, but it's effective.
You want to get after those things before they explode, right, Lamar? You know, you gotta get.
I'm not a big zit guy. You know, I'm more of an ingrown hair guy, and kind of, you know, I guess can get there.
Lamar almost blew chunks when he saw the picture. He can't handle that.
Carson Wentz. I'm gonna tell you why Carson Wentz's look so bad because they look inflamed.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's the thing about it. It's like acne's acne, but when them joints look like they are really screaming at you, that's bad, man.
Yeah.
Like, and the blinkers, you know, when you got the blinkers, you know, like,
so
you know,
weird.
Those pimples that, like, they look just around at you and they're like, you know, what's going on? You know,
it's like, it almost looked like MRSA, man.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you. Like, that almost looked like a medical issue. Yeah.
You can't do this to Lamar.
You might need to call it an EMS or something.
Lamar can't handle this.
Bring a defibrillator or something on those things.
Yeah. you can't handle that, Lamar. I'm sorry about that.
It's really gross.